So Deepika, do you have a message for young people or to kind of help them emerge stronger from a crisis like this? You could talk about your experience and how, again, you deal with it, apart from cleaning up.
Yes, I mean, again, like I said, I think the reality is very different for different people. And so, again, I'd like to state that I'm sharing some of the things that have worked for me, which is following a routine. For me, following a routine is extremely important. The thing about me is that even if I'm not following a routine, it goes into a compartment of, okay, today I am not following a routine.
So it's like a weekend off, right? It's like a weekend off at the end of a week. Yeah, you're taking a break from.
Yes, so something like that. So even if it means saying, okay, I'm going to be extremely disciplined from Monday to Thursday or Monday to Friday. And on the weekend, I'm going to sleep when I want to. I'm going to wake up when I want to. So please, this is not something that happened right at the beginning of the, it's over a period of time. You get more and more clarity about how, you want to keep evolving in the current situation. And so I'm that kind of person that even in the, what do you say? Non-structure, there is a structure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know?
It's like the, dieting all week.
I've planned and decided that on these 2 days, I'm going to not be structured. So that's also structure. If that means, in psychology, if that even means anything, I don't know. But in my mind, I know that, okay, from Monday to Thursday or Monday to Friday, these are the timings. This is when we're going to have dinner. This is the time you're going to go to sleep. This is what, this is the time I'll wake up. When we do wake up, I dedicate the first half of the day to sort of just addressing home chores. And I use the second half of the day for whatever meetings and, things that have to be addressed. Once the whole day is done, late evening is when we sort of exercise and work out. I think that's been an extremely important part of getting through a day. Medication, meditation, quality of sleep, all of those things have been extremely important for me in this time. And of course, there have been days when, like we were talking about the symptoms or the signs earlier, and different people's bodies sort of show them those signs in different ways. Like Anna pointed out, for me, it is my breath. And having lived with anxiety and depression for so many years, I can tell instantly. So, of course, I've had my days of feeling the anxiety coming back on. My breathing gets irregular. I feel a knot in my chest. But the good thing is that I have the awareness. Now, not many people will have that awareness, and that is understandable. But because I've been through my own personal journey, I've been through my own experience, and we work in the field of mental health via the foundation. You read, you understand, you tend to sort of understand more and more. And so for me, I'm today in a place, fortunately, where I can tell if the anxiety is coming on. I can tell if I have the anxiety and I've not been addressing it, and if it seems to be going into a slightly darker place, I know and I reach out for help. So I think the anxiety has been coming on a couple of days. I feel like my breath getting sort of different from most other days. And then I know the things that I need to do. I need to focus again on my breathing. I need to meditate. I need to exercise. So I know the mechanisms of how to sort of help my way out of it as well. And then, like I mentioned earlier, doing the things that are within our control and doing things that I enjoy doing, either individually, alone on my own, or whether it's with my husband, doing things that we enjoy doing and putting a system or a process in place.
So it's really about training yourself how to listen to your body and how to deal with the situation.
Yes, that does not, it does not happen. It doesn't happen overnight. And I mean, most often the symptoms will always most often be physical symptoms. And it's important for us to kind of, over a period of time, recognize that, embrace that, and then seek help.